Good morning, everyone. It is the start of a new day, and for today's agenda, I want to try something different. I want to get involved, try different things, and do different things, etc. But today's agenda, or first attempt at this, I have a really good friend, Walter. He's an amazing photographer, and I kind of just want to spend the day with him. And he wants to do like headshots and photos and everything of me. So I'm actually gonna go pick him up. I have, I guess, this interview or this idea of how I wanted this video. Not sure how the end result's gonna come out, but yeah, I wanna ask him some stuff. It's gonna be just talking while doing the videos, etc. But anyways, I'm gonna go pick him up right now and probably head to the park, do this little quick interview thing, and then just head out and see what shots we can get. But yeah, all right, see you guys there. Let's go.
Yeah, we got some shots at the lake and everything, and there we went into the little city area, the little, I guess, main street and everything. Just got some shots, went through the alleys, everything and all that.
Had him sitting in a bathtub filled with dirt.
Yeah, full of fucking spiders.
Some dope shots though. So first off, let me introduce myself, y'all. Yeah, he already did, but I just want to let you guys know I'm also a photographer. You can find me on Instagram at kid_idol. That's kid with two D's. KIDD_idol. My photography is everywhere, but that's my life. So, and yeah, I'm just a little personality. So if y'all want to follow me, add me, whatever, check out my work, just hit me up, you know, DM me if you're interested, and if you need some rates, just DM me. Cool guy. And just be ready for just a very different personality.
Really cool dude and everything. I had a lot of fun. This is my first time actually ever doing like shoots like that. So that was really cool and everything. I was actually really kind of nervous and everything. That's why I brought like three different different shirts, different pads and everything. I'm like, I don't know what you want from me, type of thing and all that and everything. But yeah, and everything. Like I said, go ahead and check out his work. He does dope ass shots and everything. I actually can't wait to see the ones that you got and everything, how you edit them and everything.
And I'm actually excited on quite a few of them. I got some dope headshots too, like some really dope headshots. And the bathtub one is actually one of my favorites, just because like elongated view from your shoes and on. So I'm a fan of his shoes, bro. His shoes look like they're made from denim. Look like denim shoes right here, black jeans, Levi's.
I want to experience, I want to delve into other people's cultures, hobbies, everything, all that and everything. And this is, I guess, the first, I guess, instance of that and everything. I'm all, so you just photography and everything and all that. Everybody takes photographs and everything and all that. I am in no way good at editing, stuff like that. You make things pop, everything and all that. But as unprepared as I always will be and everything, I want to ask these questions. So I printed out questions. I typed up questions because I didn't know how to do this. What got you inspired and interested in photography?
So I really didn't get my camera until freshman year in high school, and I've always been interested in the camera itself until like I actually really learned how to work with it. And that was sophomore year, and I was in this multimedia technology academy, so we really got into a lot of Photoshop, editing, videography, and all that. But photography just sat with me. I was just known as a kid in high school with a camera all the time, really, and like that's just where it all really kind of started. Just
what is your goal, or what are you trying to portray, like, with each photo?
It really depends. So, like, the main goal, really, if it's with the person, I like my models or my subjects to really be themselves, because that's what it's about. It's about expressing yourself in any way possible, whether it's your personality, however you represent yourself in a picture, however they capture you. It's really you doing your thing and just being yourself. I'll take the picture at an angle that I like that looks intriguing to me, and then that's when I go in and play with the editing and be like, all right, you know, this will look better as a warmer contrasted photo, or some look better more dramatic and dark and gloomy-ish, which is weird but also cool at the same time, because sometimes that dramatic, dark and gloomy, it brings out more detail into what is in the picture too.
Anybody that's looking to do any photography or even do any type of content creator, what type of advice or whatever would you like to give them? Like something that you wish you knew when you started doing all this that you could give advice to?
Don't limit yourself on the kind of content you could put out there. I started off just wanting to do car pictures. Just cars. I love cars, but don't limit yourself to just sticking to one person. That was limiting me from really learning from so many different things. Like, don't just try to stick to one thing. Broaden your horizon and expand in all different categories of photography that you like, you know? Or any type of just content that you're trying to put out there. For for other videographers, photographers, artists, any type of artist, painters, drawers, anything, you know, fuck what everybody else thinks, bro. Like, just a lot of people tell me to say fuck it, and I've been working on that, slowly getting over that hump. But yeah, I'd say just put your work out there, bro, whether people like it or not. Don't even worry about who likes it or not. Don't worry about any of that. Just put it out there. Keep pushing content. You got to be prolific with it. You got to keep pushing and pushing. Because eventually, all those, I don't like it, is going to be relevant. And that one that says, I love it, let me buy it off you, all of a sudden, bam, you have a $1,000, $15,000 painting that you just sold that you never expected to go for. That's it.
That was really fucking weird. Just that guy just fucking coming in. I thought he was gonna steal my phone for a minute.
He like ran it over.
Yeah, that's exactly how I was just like, well, either this guy's gonna run it over or he's just gonna just swipe this phone and just fucking take it. Everything. And I'm just like, my ass is not meant for running. Type of shit. I'm just like,
my ass is not meant for, I wanna chase that down.
Everything. I'm just like,
I guess the big question, everything would be with your, I guess with your photography and everything. Let's say if you, it would blow up. And everything, which I do hope you like, you have an amazing talent. I really hope the best and everything, like for everything. All I really hope you blow up and everything. Once you do, I hope you remember us, little people, and all that.
And little people, like I said, like we had this conversation earlier. If I was a billionaire, bro, nobody would even know. I'd still be dressed casual like this, or like I said, I'd dress in my Nike slides, basketball shorts, and the shirt all day, every day. No one would know, bro. Like, I'd have the money. I'd have, like, my car, my house, and family. But no one would know. I'm still regular human being, and I'd rather interact with people than try to be rich and be away from everybody and be distant, you know? I crave human interaction. Like, it's always constant. You always need someone to talk to. So I can't. Don't forget nobody. Obviously, I came from the Bay back here, so. If I was to blow up, though, I'd do a lot more giving than taking. Receiving, to be honest, like at the end of the day,
where do you want to like your photography to be? Like, do you want it to be like a museum thing? Like, where would you like to see it portrayed? Like,
I like to be a star in porno, but I'm playing. Nah, really, my goal is I want to be able to have my own studio, and what I mean by studio, besides just somewhere to shoot in, I want to be able to have my own little team so I can do like weddings, big events, you know? Like, that's really it. I more want to see my photos in magazines, if anything. I'm not someone that likes to be in front of the camera, so that whole star famous stuff, all that, yeah. I'm cool on all that. Like, I don't need the limelight. I'd rather be the person in the shadows or hustling right there. But, I want my own studio, my own little team to do certain things, make sure they get their money's worth too, because as an artist, you gotta help each other artists, even if it's not in your own specific, like, category. Like, you're into videography, I'm into photography.
Yeah.
So, they're similar, but they're different, yeah. You know? So, like, there's a way where videography helps with my photography and seeing the whole picture.
Yeah.
You know, just everything. And then there's aspects where my photography can help your videography at the same time. So it's like, as an artist or even as painters, drawers, everything, like, every artist has some type of advice to help another artist.
Exactly.
And I think it's mostly because we're all our biggest critics, so we're hard on ourselves. So, like, having that advice from another artist to help you kind of get over that little hump.
Yeah, that little...
Your little, like, self-hump.
Yeah.
Yeah, it helps a lot. So it's really it, really it. Like, just bring other creatives together.
We're all here hustling, just trying to make it big with our work, get our work out there.
Yeah. And I think that's the hardest part, is really marketing your artwork. That's like the hardest part of all of it.
Marketing. Like you said, we're our own self-critics, so it's just like, we want to get our stuff out there, but we're so harsh on ourselves, we're just like, it's not good enough. And everything, when in reality, it is good enough, but we just got to put it out there and just let it
happen. Yeah. I'm excited. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go home and just start editing in my room.
No, I can't wait for it, but thank you again. Like I said, I'm going to put all of his social media and everything, and all of you guys can take a look at his photos and everything and all that. But yeah, go ahead and give this guy freaking a follow and everything. Like, his photos are super fucking dope.
I don't know if he's going to put it right here.
Everything. We'll do something. I'll do something right here.
This area right here? I don't know.
It'll be somewhere right here. And everything and all that. But yeah, and everything and all. Thank you again, dude. And everything and all. I'm definitely going to see
you. Like my stick?
Just imagine, like, it just stopped recording. Was there
the whole time?
Right.